Good evening, everybody, and welcome to tonight's regularly scheduled Planning Commission meeting of January 8th, 2014. May we have a roll call, please?
Commissioner Bush.
Here.
Commissioner Coates. Commissioner Cooper.
Here.
Soon to be Commissioner Wilkes. Commissioner Manfredi.
Here. Okay, would everyone please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, liberty and justice for all.
Thanks, everybody. Okay, we'll go to Section C, and tonight we have the administration of the oath of office for our newest planning commission. Both Commissioner Bush and I have already taken the oath.
I am Timothy Wilkes, do solemnly swear to or affirm that I will support and defend the Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of the State of California against all enemies, foreign and domestic, that I will bear true faith and allegiance to the Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of the State of California, that I take this obligation freely without any mental reservation or the purpose of evasion, and that I will well and faithfully discharge the duties upon which I am about to enter.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Okay, we'll go right to public comments, and public comments is an opportunity to address the Planning Commission on items of interest to the public that do not appear on the agenda. Comments should be limited to 3 minutes. The Commission may not take action on items raised during public comment.
Good evening, Commissioners. Chris Canning, Mayor, City of Calistoga. I wanted to first thank Mr. Wilkes for his willingness and enthusiasm in serving as now an officially sworn-in planning commissioner. So thank you and welcome aboard. And I'm sure you will serve this community quite well. We had some interesting and beneficial discussions, so you are well advised as to what you're getting into. And I would also like to thank Commissioner Manfredi and Commissioner Bush for their willingness to re-up, if you will. And continuing to serve our community. You guys do a fantastic job as a representative of the City Council. We are quite confident in the work that you do and the recommendations you pass forward to us. With that said, we've had two appeals already that we've upheld in your favor, and that should demonstrate the confidence we do have in the work you do, and whether the majority of the community understands it or not, these are very difficult roles that you take and place yourselves in, and it's not easy sitting on that side of the desk, having the stones often thrown at you from this side of the podium. So I figured I'd throw a few compliments your way. And again, thank you for all that you do for not only the council, but for the community as a whole, and welcome Mr. Wilkes.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Anyone else wish to address the commission? Okay, we'll close the public comments, and I'll ask for a motion to adopt the agenda as presented.
Motion to adopt.
Second.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Okay. There was no communication or correspondence. We have the minutes. If there are any corrections to the minutes, voice them now. No corrections. They stand approved as read. Next item of business is new business. We now have item one, which is the election of the 2014 Planning Commission office. Would anyone like to nominate any?
I would. Can I nominate both a vice chair and a chair? Is that appropriate? Let just both of them together, or do they have to be separate?
I would take them on separate.
Okay. I would like to nominate Jeff Manfredi to continue as chair.
Okay. Is there a second?
A second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. All opposed?
And if I could, I'd like to nominate Carol Bush for vice chair.
I will second that. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
All opposed?
Aye.
Okay. Congratulations, Carol. Okay, we'll go right to item two under new business, which is the Elze Design Review. It's DR 2013-9. This is a public hearing to consider the design review of a single-family residence at 1739 Emerald Drive.
Thank you, Chairman Manfredi, members of the commission. The project is located within a 17-lot subdivision entitled Center Court Subdivision. The property is subject to the R1 development standards as well as conditions of approval of the Center Court Subdivision. Within the conditions of approval of the Center Court Subdivision, it calls out the requirement for design review approval subject to the Planning Commission's adoption of a design review resolution. Staff has reviewed the application submitted by Mr. Elze, who is in contract to purchase the property. Upon approval of the Planning Commission, the property will close and Mr. Elze will acquire the property and commence construction. The architectural plans that have been submitted for the project have been found to be consistent with the R1 residential development standards. They've also been found to be consistent with the conditions of approval as expressed in the Center Court subdivision. In reviewing the project consistent with the necessary design review guidelines, we found that the project is consistent with the neighborhood. It provides a unique design that is not repetitive with the other residents. Although Mr. Elze has constructed other residential dwelling units in this subdivision, it is subtly different from those others, so it's not creating a spontaneous situation within the subdivision. Mr. Elze has submitted a color board here that presents subtle brown hues that will accent the existing developments in the area, as well as the landscaping that Mr. Elze has presented in his landscaping plan. The siding is hardy shingle as well as hardy panel above the garage. We believe there's some nice architectural accents above the garage and with the dormers that will provide a aesthetic quality along the street frontage. With that said, again, we do support the project as presented in the attached design review resolution with the attached findings and conditions of approval. With that said, if the Planning Commission has any questions of us, I can answer those now. Thank you.
Okay, do any commissioners have any questions for staff at this time? Okay, would the applicant like to say anything? You just give your name and address if you would.
Wayne Elze, P.O. Box 9277, Santa Rosa. I don't have a lot to add to the staff report. We did try to address the privacy issues of the property to the south by limiting the window treatments in the on that side of the home. And then we have a single living area window in that side of the home that we're going to deal with a glass block type of treatment, so the privacy, try to maintain as much privacy between the neighbors as possible. And we've also proposed on the site plan a 6-foot fence and with 2-foot lattice on top to get a little bit more privacy from neighbor to neighbor. Other than that, I think it'll be a nice addition to the development, and I'd be happy to answer any questions that anybody might have during the plan.
Does anyone have any questions, please?
First off, Mr. Elze, I'd like to compliment you on your proposal. The design is very much in keeping with the other houses on the street. I think it'll be a great addition. A couple of questions. I noticed on your site plan you have a concrete driveway proposed, and a number of the driveways in that subdivision have used colored concrete, not just straight concrete. That would be one question of whether you'd thought about that. Or secondly, have you thought about the prospect of using permeable paving that would be able to absorb water There are a couple of homes on the street that have used permeable paving.
I don't believe there are in that development that have.
Yeah, there's one across the street.
As far as the
driveway.
The driveway, yeah. I hadn't considered that, no. We have used the subtle color in the concrete and the other homes that we've done over there, that I've done over there that have a variable pattern in them to kind of break up the monotony of the mm-hmm. of the just a flat concrete driveway, give it a little bit of interest there. But that's the proposal at this point, is to use regular concrete.
So you would propose not to use color in this house?
Propose to use a real subtle color. Yeah, there's subtle color in the others too.
All right. Thank you. That's all.
Any other questions of the applicant while he's here? Okay, thank you.
Thanks.
Okay, with that, I'll open it up to commission discussion. Any, is there anything anyone would like to add or comment on?
Mr. Manfredi, I know that there's others in the audience. I don't know if the public hearing is still open.
Would anyone else wish to address the commission regarding this particular item?
Thank you.
Okay, we'll close the public portion and open it up to commission discussion. Commissioner Bush?
Well, it looks like you've dotted all your I's and crossed all your T's. I like the design. Well done.
Okay. Yes.
I would propose, I agree with Commissioner Bush. The based on what the applicant has just said, I would like to see the motion include colored concrete in the driveway to the approval of staff, as it's not currently noted on the plans.
Okay. How do the other commissioners feel about that?
I'm fine with that, and I do know, I've known Mr. Elsie for decades. He does a fine job, as demonstrated if you go out and look at his home. So I feel quite good that we're getting a quality home, and we're actually getting some new construction in town, because yeah. We are, I think a gentleman that sent a letter and has echoed that, we are in desperate need of housing. And so I think this is a very good thing. And I do agree with your suggestion on the concrete as well.
Okay.
Now, is this a spec house, or is it built owner-occupied? Okay, good. So basically, any happy, lucky buyer can approach it. Yes, and I agree. It sounds like the color element's already
you
been
pre-approved,
added
Scott?
To it. I do.
Yeah.
But it sounds like Mr. Halsey already does have that that color component into the driveway. So yeah, sounds great. Love the plans, and certainly like to see more of that in this area.
Okay, I have nothing to add. Eric, I think there's a consensus that it should be worded clearly that the driveway should have some color component rather than just...
How about this? Prior to building permit issuance, subtle color shall be added to the concrete driveway subject to review and approval of the Planning and Building Department.
Perfect. Okay, with that, would someone like to make the first motion of 2014?
I'll make the motion.
Should make the new guy do it.
I move that the Planning Commission adopt a resolution approving design review application DR2013-9 for a new residence at 1739 Emerald Drive.
With the
element of color added to it.
Okay, is there a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye. Aye.
All opposed? Okay. Good luck. You're welcome. Okay, the third item tonight is the amendments to the public safety and public service elements of the Calistoga General Plan, GPA 2014-1. It's a public hearing to consider recommending general plan amendments to the City Council.
Thank you. As you know, we will be updating the housing element this year as required by state law. And also as required by state law, before we update the housing element, we also have to update the public safety element, specifically to update, reflect any changes to flooding information and also to fire hazards, wildland fire hazards. So With that in mind, working backwards, we've been working to update the public safety element. And as you'll see in the written staff report, we've incorporated the 2008 flood insurance rate maps. And we also provide extensive information on wildfire potential prevention, all the goals and policies that go along with that. That was a challenging part of it. We have to run that by CAL FIRE for their review, and I think we were the first one in because they didn't quite know what to do with it. You're supposed to submit it to you for review. And so in the end, there was a little bit back and forth, but between the fire chief and I, we were able to secure their acceptance of the fire safety section of it, the wildland fire safety section. It's also led into needed revisions to the public services element because there's a section in there about fire service. So we had to keep going and make some changes to that section of public services element. So that's not a wholesale change like the public safety element is. We went from the very beginning of public safety all the way through and updated that while we were there. It's been 10 years since there's been, you know, a comprehensive look at it. So we've given you red line versions and then also the proposed clean copy of the elements. We don't feel that any specific environmental review is required because there's no possibility that these changes could have a significant effect on the environment. In fact, it's going to have a positive effect on the environment by protecting people from flooding, minimizing wildland fire. And so the commission's role in this instance is to make a recommendation to the city council, and that's what we're recommending that you do this evening. I'd be happy to answer any questions.
Okay, do any commissioners have any questions of staff at this time?
I have just one question. It's really a clarification. I think it's a words, there's something you could do in a word search through here. There's a lot of references to the Uniform Building Code, and there is no Uniform Building Code any longer. There's the California Building Code, which is based on the International Building Code. So that could probably just be done as a global search.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. I appreciate that.
Good point. Okay, this is a public hearing. If there's anyone in the public wish to comment, okay. Pat, you have nothing to add. Okay, I'll open it up to commission discussion, if any.
I nothing much to say. I except the amount of work that was put into this. It's not thrilling stuff. So you've got to applaud staff for all the work that they did and how if you read the whole thing, I read it twice.
I thought it was a real nail biter.
Yeah, and boring, but they you can see they put a lot of time into it, and I think that you need to be noted for that because it's not exciting at any stretch of the imagination. But if you read it, you did a good, in my opinion, you did a very good job. So, and especially coming from being a fire chief and things in the past and looking at the issues that are being dealt with and updating everything, I think you did a really good job, and I think you needed to be recognized for that. So
I second that comment.
I third it.
Okay. Commissioner Bush, how would you like to make your first motion as the vice chair?
I move that the Planning Commission adopt a resolution recommending to the City Council approval of amendments to the public safety and public services elements.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Okay, we come to section I, at which time any commissioner can bring up anything they'd like to. Seeing no one, we'll go to the director's report.
Thank you. That the commission cancel its January 22nd meeting. We don't have any business items for you for that meeting. So, you know, the meetings stand unless they're canceled by you. So I would recommend by voice vote that you agree to cancel the January 22nd meeting.
Okay. Want to make a roll call vote?
I just go for it.
Aye.
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 Okay. Okay, the meeting of January 22nd has officially been canceled.
Okay.
And
now and coincidentally, there is a planning commissioner workshop that's going to be offered on that night in St. Helena. And all comers are welcome, all decision makers that want to learn a little more about the planning basics. The beginning will be about specifically about planning commissioners and their roles with staff and the public and the council. And but it's going to also be very broad topics such as ethics and transparency and how to run a meeting. And then it's going to get into, you know, what's a general plan, zoning ordinance, zoning regulations. What else is on there? So appeals. So it's free. You're welcome to come. You don't need to RSVP. I think it'll probably take a couple of hours. It's going to be just informal. We've invited commissioners from all over the valley and again, any other decision makers that are interested in just some planning basics. I did want to note that the mayor sent a letter to Commissioner Kuzner thanking him for his service to the community during his tenure as a commissioner for the last couple of years. So with that, I would recommend that you adjourn the meeting to February 12th.
Okay, I'll make a motion that we adjourn tonight's meeting until our next scheduled meeting of February 12th?
Yes.
2014.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Okay.